Yo, what's up guys? Welcome back to TCG Metagame Breakdown for like August 2020. This is still OC, well, this is like still online format, right? So keep that in mind that, again, due to COVID-19, we don't have in real life tournaments yet. So again, keep this in mind, online tournaments, and let's take a look at the first one here being the Luxury Championship Series, the fifth one, if I'm not mistaken. And as you see here in the representation, 100 players participated over like the weekend, past weekend, right? The reason why it has been quite a while since the last metagame breakdown, but you know, we have like new engines, new cards, and to see how much of an impact stuff like Forbidden Droplet has in a TCG, and how many players are main decking and or side decking stuff like Three Tactical Talents, again one of those very hyped up cards, right? And you know, maybe Dogmatica, how much of an impact that engine has, seeing that it's super splashable. The format as a whole, 100 players, super diverse, I guess, was, you know, anxiously awaiting how Numeron would do in this quote-unquote new format as well. If you zoom in into like the top 8 breakdown, we see a lot of diversity. You see both pie charts here, and the first thing that caught my attention was Dragonlink still strong, you know, the FTK that won a couple of weeks ago, but both Dragonlink players did not opt to main deck or you know, like play the FTK variant. Decklist will be shown within the next couple of moments. All sources will be in the video description, by the way. Eldritch still doing good. I mean, do Eldritch Dogma and, you know, one Synchro variant, and a lot of diversity. We see, you still see one Adamancipator, only one Infernoble Knight. I'm expecting more of this deck more soon. Megalith, this is an interesting one, as we have seen in the OCG as well. It did quite well over there as well, and I mean, if the player is known to play the deck, does know like every combo piece or, you know, combo, then obviously he'll do well. And last but not least, Invoked Dogma. Let's take a look. This is the winner, David, going first here with, I think, and that's the same for the other Dragonlink player, is 60 cards. Seems to be the standard, I guess, for Dragonlink. Again, as I mentioned before, he's not main decking slash running the FTK cards, indeed it's an engine, but you know, the deck presentation seems to be a bit odd, but you know, like starters, extenders, engine cards, etc., hand traps, and that's why. But I mean, he was drawing really well. If you've seen the finals, he was playing against Megalith. It was 1-1, and I believe he went second in game number 3, and he opened like Forbidden Droplet against the opponents like Magician of Black Chaos, or you know, like prevent your and you'll see how Megalith works. If you don't know, it has the ability to Azathoth. Well, not really Azathoth, but it has like two cards in like the main and side deck that says to your opponent, nope, you can't play the game. And well, David was quite lucky, I guess, but again, it's part of the game of having that droplet as well in the finals. But nonetheless, Dragonlink still like one of the best deck, if not the best deck with the highest ceiling. Who knows? The second place list, this is the most interesting one, I feel, and that's something we've seen in the OCG, where Megalith already did some cool stuff, did good, but again, their format is a bit different, and obviously they also have Maxi, but there's a live profile up on YouTube. If I find it again, I'll leave a link in the video description of the Lundriti, I hope I pronounced your name right, Lundriti Velen, right? Second place. Interesting one, 44 cards in the main deck. The thing with this is that thanks to, well, the biggest gimmick, I guess, as I mentioned before, is that the deck has the ability to, like, Azathoth your opponent during their turn with either like the King Calamity, the level 12 Synchro monster you see here in the side deck. The reason or the possibility to make it is with Needle Fiber or Helki Fibrix during your opponent's turn, tag it out for Formula Synchron, and then go from there. You need like, let's say, a level 2 tuner, like Gamma that can be, which is special summoned off of Fiber, and then, you know, your level 8 Synchro, which could be like a Boral Savage. So all cool, and then you know your opponent can't activate anything, can't play anything, plus your opponent cannot chain, I believe, do it. So quite of a ridiculous card, and the same for like the Magician of the Black Magician of the Chaos Max, right? Also says that your opponent can't play the game. So as a whole, the deck is quite ridiculous. Block Dragon is still like ridiculously broken in the deck because you can search up to like 4 cards if you're able to get like a Block Dragon off. Not really sure if it's like the biggest choke point if you like negate or prevent your opponent from like searching or getting off a Block Dragon, well, prevent them from searching with something like Granite. But nonetheless, it will be like, let's say if Konami does hit like Block Dragon, to see how much that would impact this deck. So Megaliths, definitely keep this deck, you know, in the back of your mind. Or Psytech it, Drawn and Lockbirds, who knows. Third place, another Dragon Link deck, and we see here the 3 tactical talents. Speaking of that card, is that from all the top 8 lists, only 3 of them were main decking it. So 2, 2, and 3. This particular player opted to run 2 in the main deck, even though, you know, in the OCG it's a bit better due to them having the more flexible hand trap being Maxi. So who knows, the card we might see more play in the future, or maybe less. Same for Forbidden Droplets, it's like only one player decided to main deck 3, and this particular player opted to side deck those. Let's move on, Eldritch, the Synchro variant, a very small like Dogmatica engine, and no Maximus, and that's a thing here with like, you know, the Dogmatica engine is that should you main deck Maximus? Probably not, because if we see like a lot of lists, maybe not this one, but we saw that a lot of players are like preparing themselves for the Dogma matchup, right? Side decking like Entis or main decking, or yeah, putting it in their extra deck for, you know, who knows if your opponent does decide to take the risk and Maximus you, that you can like punish them with like Cyber Dragon Nova or Magaba or Entis or whatever. So yeah, this particular player William decided not to run Maximus, but you know, there is another build that is running Maximus, and I mean, higher risk, higher reward, I guess. Synchro Eldritch. Let's move on, finally. Infernal One Knights. Highly anticipated this one, and there's a small mistake here in the list. The second Dolphin should be the... what's it called? Like the small mice should have it like on screen now, right? I mean, Squeak Knight, I believe the name is. I hope I pronounced it right, but he was only running one Neospatian Aqua Dolphin. But Connector being the hand trap baiter, and considering that this is like the first week of the whole support and the deck being like full legal for us TCG players, I'm definitely expecting more Noble Knight, Inferno Noble Knight shenanigans, because again, players are just, yeah, you know, like getting to know the deck much better. One Gear Freed in the main deck, it's something that, you know, put up first turn during one of the first summons, prevent like, let's say, like Nibiru from going off. So again, highly anticipating this deck. Who knows what it's going to do in the future, especially you can confiscation your opponent light right with the smoke grenade. Let's move on. Invoked Dogmatica, this is a cute one. And again, no Maximus in the main deck, even, well, side decking, right? So I get why. Triple 3 tactical talents, that's an interesting one. And here is the one-off player in the top 8 that is main decking the 3 Forbidden Droplets, or, you know, the quick play spell. Who knows? It's definitely a side deck staple because it's so flexible and so good. Quick play spell, right? As for the rest, yeah, the trap card, the punishments, seems to be a lot in the main deck, like 1 or 2 copies, basically in any Dogmatica deck. Then the other deck, and this is an interesting one, not really sure if it's like a mistake in the list, but this particular player, Chauvin Roy, is, you know, main decking the Shadow Trap, but it's not, or he's not main decking the Winda. Not sure if it's a mistake. He is running the Extravagance in the main deck, but again, not sure why Winda is not there, because, you know, the standard Dogma engine combo leads to, you know, like into a Winda during your opponent's turn with the Shadow Trap card. But who knows, that might be a mistake. The last list here from the Luxury Game Tournament is Emancipator. It's still doing okay, even though it was like, you know, like the two deck format from a couple of months ago. It's technically still the same format and ban list, but again, name decking the double three tactical talents, the triple Dark Ruler no more, no Nibiru, that's an interesting one, and this might be a cool one for future builds of Emancipator, is that he's deciding to run like the Miracle Rupture, which is the Foolish Burial for something like the level 4. What is it? Is it like Block Golem? The level 4, right? Send it to the graveyard and then Special Summon it immediately. It's basically another level 4 on the field. But yeah, it's Emancipator. Quickly, the second tournament here, another tournament, you know, like on Facebook, your move TCG from New Zealand, if I'm not mistaken, like a 3v3 tournament. Both the first place and second place lists are up. The first place here, three lists, again, 3v3. We see Elklish Synchro with the three tactical talents in main deck. That's an interesting one to see how this card is going to impact the game, right? I mean, players are expecting it, should be playing around it, who knows? Another list, Megaliths as well, took this one first place, at least the team, and this list is a bit different, running a bit more cards, 47 cards, Necklace of Trishula as well, seeing that it's super flexible, like the small like ritual engine is bigger, and of course a couple of Emancipator cards as well. So still testing things out. Sky Strikers also nothing too spectacular, right, Mystic Mine. And then the second place list, also Sky Strikers, again, nothing too special. We also see Synchro Elklish, again, I mean, we've seen those before, and last but not least, good old school Emancipator featuring the Go 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 shenanigans. So as a conclusion, like Numeron actually did like nothing. So. Of course, this is like the first week. Can we conclude that Numeron slash Zexalock is out of the question? No, not really. I mean, it's still like the first week, first tournaments, only 100 players, online format, so who knows, Numeron, it's you know, like people wanted to play the new stuff first, like Infernoble Knights, Dogmatica, so don't count out the deck just yet. Ghost Ogre is also quite popular against that deck. Okay, guys, that's it, thanks for watching, feel free to leave a comment or like if you enjoyed the video. Beacom signing out, peace.